Bill and Ben are the most mischievous engines on Sir Topham Hatt's railway. They're kept busy pushing and pulling freight cars up and down the line that leads from the China Clay Works to the harbor yard. They like to have fun together, and they love to play tricks on the workmen. But sometimes their teasing ways can get them into trouble. One day, Edward came to see them in the yard. "I'm supposed to bring a trainload of enthusiasts to see you," he said, "but I shan't bring them if you misbehave." Bill and Ben were excited. Enthusiasts always made a fuss over them, and they were always taking their pictures. "When?" they squeaked. Edward smiled knowingly at BoCo. "Next week," he said, "but not if you don't behave." Bill and Ben promised to be as good as gold. "Is it next week?" they asked BoCo each day. BoCo enjoyed keeping the twins in suspense. "Next day never comes," he would answer mysteriously. Bill and Ben weren't worried. They kept insisting their crews polish them. "What's the hurry? It's not as if the visitors are going to eat their breakfasts off of you." At last, the big day came, and all the engines were given an extra polish. They were sparkling when the visitors arrived. Many of them had notebooks, and nearly all of them had cameras. Bill and Ben didn't know which way to look, but they loved it. They even went for rides in Bill and Ben's cabs. Their cabs were low, and many of the visitors forgot to duck. But they didn't seem to mind. The enthusiast's visit was almost over when a shunter came running up. "A ship needs moving before the tide goes out," he said. "One of you please see to it." Ben went at once, and most of the visitors went to watch. One man stayed. He had a camera that could take instant pictures. "Just one more," he kept saying. Soon even Bill grew tired of him. The photographer screwed the camera to a tripod and pointed it at Bill. "This is it," he chortled. "What a picture." Ben's fireman ran up to them. "Ben needs help. The ship's running aground and he can't move it on his own. We need your help." "Right, Bill," said his driver. "We can't wait any longer." He turned a tap, and with a hiss and a roar, Bill vanished in a cloud of steam. When the steam cleared, Bill was hurrying off to help his twin. The photographer peeled the cover off his instant picture, looked at it, and threw it down in disgust. The two engines were coupled together.
"When I say heave, heave," said Ben. "One, two, three, heave!" "Come on, come on!"
puffed the two engines. The cable stretched and tightened. At last, with a shudder, the ship slid off the mud and, hauled by the engines, glided into the water. Bill's driver found the discarded photograph on the ground. All it showed was a cloud of steam with Bill's funnel at the top.
"What a picture," remarked Bill, to no one in particular.